study life into the country.
Hi there, I'm Nick Meisner.
I'm Lisa, his wife.
Welcome to the Ready Life podcast, where we help you become as independent as possible from the system for your basic necessities like water and heat and food and the power that makes these things function. In this week's podcast, we're outside taking a little walk because it's now a balmy, what is it, 5 degrees?
Yeah, 5 or 6.
Above zero. We finally got above zero.
Yay!
It's been some crazy weather. And we got down to 24 degrees below zero. We had friends that got down to 33 degrees below zero.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's been an exceptionally cold spell. We don't usually see weather like this. In fact, it's the coldest that I have personally experienced here in many, many years. And it's been quite eye-opening, I must say. Quite an eye-opening experience. I can't tell you how many friends we have who had frozen pipes in their house or couldn't start their car, couldn't get a generator to start, things like this. And it's kind of brought some things home, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has.
Yeah.
It was interesting. We found ourselves really worried about our friends who didn't have wood heat, particularly because, you know, with power outages and the local gas company here sent a notice out to everyone saying, you know, they needed to cut, they were having shortages and they needed everybody to cut back on their gas usage.
Natural gas.
At a time when we were sinking down into minus, you know, 20 to minus 33, depending on the exact area you were in. And man, you know, we're reaching out to friends and family, making sure everybody was okay. But yeah, that was...
The ones that we didn't worry so much about, though, were the folks that were heating with wood.
Mm-hmm.
Because we knew that no matter what happened, as long as, you know, even if their pipes froze up or what have you, we knew that they would at least be able to stay warm and make it. And I mean, if push came to shove, they could melt snow on the stove or something like that,
mm-hmm.
you know, on their wood stove. But we knew that they would be okay. They might deal with some inconveniences, but they would be okay. But the folks that were using heating systems that depended on electricity to some extent or on natural gas,
mm-hmm.
they were the ones we were really concerned about because, you know, there were power outages during that time span. And then, like you mentioned, the natural gas shortage right at this critical moment.
Yeah.
And it was
everybody's cranking their furnaces up.
Yeah.
It's so cold.
So it was very unsettling and just really helped me appreciate with renewed appreciation the importance of wood heat. I know for some folks, they maybe feel like it's inconvenient or whatever. And, you know, you either have to go and cut your wood out in the forest or you have to buy it. And for some folks, it's possible. I mean, if you're in an area where buying firewood is very expensive and electricity is cheap, it might even be a little more expensive. But in most of the cases, though, it's going to be much cheaper to heat with wood. But regardless mm-hmm. of the money, what it really brought home to me was the independence of this and the security, the heat security of knowing that no matter what happens, you've got a supply of wood and you could heat your home. You could keep your family warm in a time like this when you most need heat.
Yeah. And, you know, even in our situation, we have a drafty North Idaho.
Well-ventilated.
Well-ventilated North Idaho cabin. And even with our situation, it wasn't built very well. And so there's a lot of areas where, especially our bathroom, is where we had to battle freezing pipes. And but you know what we did? We just put more wood on the fire and cranked it up as hot as we could, and set up a couple of fans to blow the heat into the bathroom to keep those pipes from melting. And there was a couple of times we had to get up in the night and run the blow dryer on the pipes just to make sure they didn't freeze. But yeah,
heat tape.
Yeah, yeah, we had some heat tape that we had plugged in.
And the one of our big power consumers during that spell was actually for the animals, not for ourselves.
Yeah, that's
true.
Because
that was kind of a lesson learned, was with the turkeys and the chickens and all of that, trying to keep them alive, because they were, we had some close calls with them.
We did.
So running heat lamp and hot plate and stuff like this.
Heated water buckets.
Right. Which we did off the grid. We plowed through a lot of power, a lot more power than we usually do. But, you know, it's one of those things. You just have to do it. And so we made it, but it was really comforting to know that if all else failed, we got the wood, toss another log on the fire, mm-hmm. and we'd be warm, we'd be okay. And, you know, we were friends that didn't have that. We were saying, if you get your back up against a wall, you come and stay with us. We'll put out, we have a very small home. We'll put out an air mattress on the floor. You may not be super comfortable, but you'll be warm.
That's right.
And it was just, it brought home something that we already knew, but illustrated and helped me to be so thankful for our source of heat. And just want to encourage you that whatever your situation is, to come up with a good, renewable, non-electric source of heat, mm-hmm. where you can keep your family warm. Because of all of the basic necessities of life, you might think that water or food are more important than heat, but in most climates in the wintertime, it's the cold that can kill you faster than anything else. You know, mm-hmm. it can kill you within minutes when it's in temperatures like that. Whereas water, it's days, and food, you know, weeks potentially.
Yeah.
And so all of these are important, but the heat is really, really important. And yes, there's other options. You don't have to use wood heat all the time, but I still say, just like every well needs a hand pump, every home needs a wood stove and a good supply of wood, whether or not you use it on a regular basis.
That's right. That's right.
So that's all we got to say today. We're going to get back inside because it's kind of chilly out here. So.
And it's nice and warm inside.
Yeah. So we'll talk to y'all later. Hope you have a good week.
And stay warm.
That's right. Bye now.